So this next patient has talked to a couple urologists. One is doing a transperineal biopsy and the other one's doing a transrectal biopsy. The patient's read that the transperineal is preferable and they would like to know why.
Well, the advantage of a transperineal biopsy is that it doesn't go through the rectal wall and therefore the risk of complicating infections is lower. That's the main advantage. There's other disadvantages with perineal biopsies because you're, instead of going through a very short distance through the rectal wall into the prostate, you're going through a lot of tissue. It's a much longer distance to go through the perineum to get a needle into the prostate. It's a more involved process. It's more uncomfortable to do transperineal biopsies. But if someone is thinking of doing a random biopsy where they're going to stick the prostate multiple times, the risk of infection when you go through the rectum is about 1 to 2%. I'm talking about serious infections. And I'm talking about people that are doing it properly with prophylactic antibiotics and all the other measures that are usually implemented. The transperineal biopsies are advantageous in that regard. We've been doing targeted biopsies now for many years in the office where instead of doing a dozen sticks, we'll do two or three biopsies just at the lesion of interest. And we haven't had any infections now for a number of years. So it seems that you can do transrectal biopsies in a targeted fashion with very, very low risk of infection. And it's certainly a lot more convenient and not as uncomfortable.
This next question comes from a patient who has a urologist who scheduled their biopsy to be 5 weeks out, and they would like to know if this is a safe amount of time to wait.
People get very anxious when they hear the word cancer, and I can't tell you how many times over and over I want to stress how different prostate cancer is from the other scary types of cancers out there, like lung cancers and pancreas cancers, where 5 weeks could make a difference in those types of cancer. It will not make a difference for prostate cancer patients in terms of cure rates and their long-term future. It can have an impact emotionally. Patients have a hard time dialing down their concern when they hear the word cancer, especially when they're newly introduced to this prostate world where things move at such a slower pace. There have been a number of studies looking at people having delays in treatment for 6 to 12 months after diagnosis, and they get the same cure rates as people who are treated immediately. So there's no risk to waiting 5 weeks, but there's always an emotional struggle, and people want to get out of the ambiguity, find out what's going on, and it's much more comfortable if things can be done quickly. But it's not medically dangerous to wait.
Hey everyone, it's me, Alex, and our mascot, Hunter. You can check out his Instagram, Sir Hunter the Dow, at the link below. Don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel, and in fact, if this dog high-fives me, high-five, high-five, can you high-five me? Thank you. You have to subscribe. Go subscribe to the YouTube channel. He even thinks it's awesome. Also, don't forget to visit our website, PCRI.org.